Heavenly Father, for allowing us to be here. Yeah. It's been a tremendous journey in our lives, and it's been a tremendous journey in the lives of those who have bravely given up their home country and come to a safe place to get a new start, whether it's temporary or permanent. In the meantime, these precious people are concerned for their loved ones that are still in their occupied territories. Teresa and I have had the privilege to minister in Ukraine since 2014 when we adopted our beautiful twins with Down syndrome, Sammy and Alex, from an orphanage in Odessa. As much as we wanted to take home every little child and love on them, we knew it was impossible. But God, it was He who was calling us to deliver His love and compassion as we had gone over Ukraine over a combined total of 40 different times. We had the privilege of ministering in orphan camps, local churches, and orphanages together. And God used us to travel to every region of the country over the years, speak in universities, speak in conferences, teach parents, churches, and school administrators from all over that country about children with special needs and how they're made perfect in God's image and how to love them unconditionally, because that's what Agape Ministries Incorporated exists to do. So, in January of 2022, after a long time of prayer and gathering all of our documents, getting them in order, resigning from jobs and leaving our home here in Vermont, we took our family to Ukraine with the intent of moving there permanently. And a month later, we had to come back home as war was about to break out, and it was for real. Devastated, crushed, and confused as to what was next, someone from our board of directors said, we need to open up a home for Ukrainian refugees because it's going to be inevitable that the United States is going to see people come from Ukraine, and we still need to minister to them. So God gave us the vision, and in 4 months' time, miraculously, I may add, we closed on a beautiful 11.25-acre piece of property with an over 11,000-square-foot building. It was formerly known as the Derby Green Nursing Home, and now has become the Agape House of Mercy, where my family and, I believe, 26 people from Ukraine with special, many with special needs, from physical needs to autism to medical needs and even Down syndrome. We live together so they can start a new life in a safe place. None of which would be possible if it weren't for God, the power of prayer, and a compassionate community of plumbers, electricians, local businesses, carpenters, local churches who seek justice, love mercy, and walk humbly with God for such a time as this. So once again, we thank you for being here tonight, supporting us. And I can tell you that words sometimes seem not to be enough for the gratitude that we have for all of you and for these wonderful musicians tonight. We've got together to give their gift of music to all of us here tonight. And as a token of our appreciation, we wish for you to sit back and enjoy some of the most beautiful music by some of the most talented musicians anywhere.
Face times of extreme difficulty, sometimes comforting to reach to a higher power. And if you're willing, join me this evening. We'll just ask a blessing of what we're doing this. Our Father, as we're gathered here, we ask your blessing on the musicians of the work and on the people of not only Ukraine but any place where there's oppression and adversity. We ask this in your name. The first two, if you look at your program, second, third pages, and down, describe what's going to be happening this evening and introduce you to some of the musicians. You'll notice, if you look at the program, that the first two pieces of music played are the National Anthem of the United States and the National Anthem of Ukraine. As the musicians play, We invite you to stand. You're welcome to sing. Now, I won't be able to sing much in Ukrainian, and vice versa. However, pick your anthem that you can sing, and if you'd like to join in, you're welcome to. But please stand to recognize and honor the two nations.
the song is about something special to every Ukrainian. And it is, the song is called Embrace Me. The song was written long before the war started, but when the war started, the song became very popular. Why? Because, you know, during the war, this time of sadness and of, I would say, even more than just sadness, yeah? You know the words, of course. What war could bring, right? Everyone during this time, every person, every Ukrainian becomes your brother, becomes your sister, becomes your family. That's why this song is very emotional for every Ukrainian. And, you know, when somebody loses his family, other person becomes his family or her family. So thank you for your time.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you.
There's another way that you can participate that you might not have noticed in the entryway. There's a table with someone selling tickets there. That's because first violinist is making a music stand. And if you might be interested in it, you might want to visit the table out there. I think there's a drawing at the end of the program. You see if I'm mistaken?
Yeah.
And so some lucky person will get to enjoy it. I understand it's made from locally sourced wood. And it sounds like a musician. Also, if you were a Ukrainian or from Ukraine and you didn't get a gift, by all means, see the students over here sometime during the program or afterwards. They'd love to give you what they have, some flowers and things. Thank you, and enjoy the rest of the concert.
Thank you.
Well, what a blessing it is to be able to share music. Music transcends all language barriers. And we're really grateful for what we've heard tonight. And for the encouragement that each of you have brought here tonight to the Agape House, to the Ukrainians. And this speaks to the American spirit. Beyond borders of what we want to open our arms to welcome people into our country of hope. Tonight, we want to end up sharing our last call for that music stand, if anybody's interested in getting the raffle tickets for that. That's something really, really special. And take an opportunity to be able to get that. Jim, did you have something you wanted to share about that? Okay, yep. And then we've got a special gift that the Ukrainians want to share with some special people.
We've been busy in the back the last few minutes. We had to find a big box to gather the money that was contributed.
Here we are.
Kind of lifting it from the hallway. Scott, we're going to give this to you. There's just over $4,500.
Speechless, and that's not a usual thing for anyone who knows me. I can't thank each and every one of you enough, and I hope I speak on behalf of. It's not about me and Teresa. It's not about anything but God's compassion and love for his people. And we're so grateful. And just so you know, every penny we ever get, everything tonight, and everything gotten and everything we will get, it all goes 100% to help people start a new life in a new place. And bills cost money, and that's how we operate. We are beyond eternally grateful for this and for all the support you and everyone has given.
So I got a little ahead of myself there. I understand that there's a gift that wants to be given by the Ukrainians to two special people that had something to do with this tonight. And so we've got Kathy Charles Ring. Round of applause for what they're doing.
to this country. I'd like to us also to think about and consider the fact that it was not that long ago that our brothers and sisters from Ukraine came here with little more than backpacks, with many bringing unspeakable baggage of trauma and suffering that they had to go through, and that even now family members back there are having to suffer with and go through, and they carry that with them as well. The Agape House has given them a hope chest for that backpack of safety and a faith as a guide, surrounded by the assistance with paperwork to do, the unbelievable amount of paperwork and stuff that they have to do, help with learning their English. They've had months of classes for the children that have happened, a place where love abides, safe from bombs and the need for fleeing to bomb shelters. I've been a carpenter cabinet maker for 38 years. And every so often I find myself at the start of the day stopping and taking a look at these fingers that are so amazingly miraculous in what they can do, and realizing that there is a high chance that something could happen to them. And so I sometimes just sit there before I start my day and take a look and go, wow, that's amazing. Why do I share that? I encourage you, when you go home tonight, when you go to your place where you're not worried about bombs falling on you, you can lay down in that bed and find a comfortable pillow. You got a refrigerator with food, electricity that generally works, and value it, appreciate it, because there's many that don't have it. Don't take it for granted. It's easy for us to do that because it seems like it's always there. Before we close tonight, I had to make sure that there were no weapons across over here. We have another war and battle that has started recently, with Teresa having to battle stage 4B cancer. And we solicit your prayers and your support and encouragement for her as she's going through this battle. But we also know that there's many others, maybe even in this very room, that are on that same journey with that same battle. And we're all been touched by it. And it's a war all around. So if you don't mind, as we close, let's bow our heads in prayer. Amen. Father in heaven, it is a gift that we want to show great appreciation for. This freedom bought at so great a cost that we've experienced and have had the privilege of having for so many years. Oh Lord, have mercy upon those who are suffering. Lord, we pray and plead for an end to this war in Ukraine and the unspeakable suffering and trauma that's going on over there. It makes no sense. But we are so grateful that you are coming to put an end to that. And so we plead for mercy, for hope and grace, and your blessings upon the House of Mercy, Teresa, and all those others that are suffering from cancer. Help them with their journey. Bring healing, hope, and joy in you. We pray in your name. And we also pray, Lord, in a special way, you prepare the roads before us as each one of us head back home to a place of safety tonight. In your name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Okay. Thank you. I think this is amazing. We have something for special people that people have spoken about. This is a spiritual journey that many of you have heard, My wife is right here in the front. She's a cancer survivor, by the way. She'll cut me off if I talk too long. But it's a God-given mission to play with these folks, these young people, too, and the choir has been inspirational for me. We have two gifts of appreciation. I think of these two special people that have, their spirits, two women that have driven us for playing and for this whole thing. And I think of her as Mother Teresa. She's amazing. What she has done, bringing people with her husband Scott here, as he discussed when we started, it's an amazing journey. She's a spiritual leader in our lives, and we love her. And we also have something, well, let me bring this over for the story. Drives people like me, and it's really good. She's such a blessing in all of our lives.